What's up, DIY Clubbers? If you're anything like me, your laundry keeps on coming. So I went to Target and got me a rolling laundry hamper, and you can come along while I put it together. Stay tuned. So of course, you know I hit up my local Target and picked up this rolling laundry hamper. And here I am just taking everything out of the box. The great thing about this kit is that it comes with every single piece that you'll need, as well as detailed instructions on how to put this together. It is not difficult and did not take me that much time. The only thing that added time to the construction of this was when I realized that I put on one of the pieces backwards, and you'll see that a little later. I started up by opening all the hardware that was included with the kit. Now, if you're not organized, I definitely suggest that you don't do this and you take it out piece by piece. But for me, it made the process easier having everything laid out so I could match with the instructions to make sure I received all my pieces and that I wouldn't have any issues later on down the line. As long as you follow the instructions, you'll do great. To begin, we're gonna add all four of our wheels to the bottom base of the rolling laundry hamper. Next, we're going to add the two lower poles that will help create the stand for our second basket to sit on. And the great thing about this kit is that all things needed are included. Now this is where I realized I messed up after I added the second pole on the opposite side. I could not get the shelf for the second basket to sit on to connect. And I was looking at the instructions and I was so confused until I realized that I had one of the poles turned around backwards. So you see here how there's the two holes and then there's only one on the other side. Those actually have to face inside. So here you see me doing the tedious process of removing the two poles so that I could get them put on correctly so that this next step was a lot easier. So once I went ahead and corrected my mistake, the shelf actually went into the grooves seamlessly. And here I am just reading the instructions to double and triple check that I had did it correctly this time, because I did not want to start over with those screws again. So as you can see, you just kind of interlock the top shelf with those grooves, and then you'll add your screws to secure it. At this point, the stand was too tall to keep it on the box, so I set it on the floor, and then I took the bottom basket and set it in the little groove just to make sure I had gotten the height correct. Like I said, I was not trying to do this for a third time. So we're going to continue on adding our second set of poles for our second shelf, making sure that the grooves are facing the correct way. Add your screws to secure it and move to your next step. Repeat on the other side to add your second pole to the top half of the hamper. Lastly, we're going to add our third set of poles. This is going to create the top of the hamper, and we're of course securing with our screws. Again, you can adjust the height of the top portion of the hamper, and it comes in handy because you can hang clothes on there if you so choose. Once you've connected the top portion of the hamper, you can then go ahead and add your two baskets that come in the kit. And here here is the rolling laundry hamper completed. I have used this thing so much since I recorded this video. I will definitely say it works better on tile or hardwood floors, not so much carpet, but it definitely works and is handy. Thanks for joining me for another video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and turn on the bell for notifications. Share this video with a friend and head over to IG to follow my Instagram page, Haiku Creations. Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, I hope you're having a great day and always keep creating. All right, love you guys. Bye.